The Fellowship event is here, but it can be a lot to keep track of how much you're supposed to level buildings, what levels your overseers should be, and which tasks you should be skipping. Enter my event spreadsheet, which is linked down below. It'll keep track of everything for you. However, there's a lot going on, so this video is just going to be going over all of its features and how to use them. Just a warning though, it is made for use with Google Sheets. If you try to download it as an Excel spreadsheet, some things might not work. First, let's get you a copy of the spreadsheet. The link in the description will allow you to copy the spreadsheet so that you can interact with it. When you copy it, a message mentioning an attached app script file will pop up. Click OK. The script is only used to reset some of the checkboxes in the spreadsheet automatically. Note that you will have to copy a separate spreadsheet for each new city, as this sheet only supports one world at a time. Now that you've got a copy of the spreadsheet, feel free to follow along with the video. The first page is just a short guide on how to use the spreadsheet, where you'll also find the link to this video. You can also find the links for my other event videos, as well as Mooing Cat's spreadsheet and videos on how to run through each town. He did a really good job with them, and they can be handy as another way to check your progress. The optimal task completion, building levels, and overseer upgrades that I used in this sheet are based on his work, so please go check his channel out. The second page, which you can get to via the tabs on the bottom, is the interface. This is where you'll be spending the majority of your time in this spreadsheet. This dropdown allows you to choose which town variant you're currently working on. For the first town of the minigame, I recommend choosing the first town option, which allows you to end the town with only 1 million feast provisions instead of 8.4 quadrillion. After choosing the town, click this checkbox. It'll reset the task progress checkboxes, so only do this after completing a town. You'll have to uncheck and recheck it to reset the checkboxes once again. Below the town selection and reset, you'll find the to-do list. This is the most important part of the spreadsheet. This will show you what you should be doing in the minigame, step by step. As you complete them, simply check off the boxes. These are also color-coded. The green boxes represent the actual tasks that you have to complete for the minigame. The yellow boxes are my suggestions on what to level and in what order, and the red boxes are tasks that you should skip. These are also marked with a lock icon. As you check off the boxes, quite a few things will happen. First, you'll see any tasks you complete be added to your total of tasks completed, taken out of the recommended number of tasks to complete in the town variant you've chosen. Additionally, any gemstones you should have spent will be updated in the gemstone spent box. Again, take it out of the recommended number to be spent. In the your current tasks box, completed tasks will disappear and be replaced with the next new task, just like in the minigame. If you're ever lost, make sure that these three tasks are the same as the ones shown in the game. Below that box, you'll find one of my favorite parts of the spreadsheet. A list of each building and their overseers with the levels that each should be at depending on which tasks you've completed. This is a great way to check if you're doing everything correctly. I ask that you don't touch anything to the right of these boxes though. If you change any of the formulas, it could result in incorrect info being shown on this sheet. Our next page is the grand prizes sheet. This one is a bit simpler. All you have to do here is enter the number of tasks you've completed for each town, which is shown at the top of the previous sheet, and select whether you've purchased the silver or gold event passes. Off to the right, you'll see your progress through the grand prizes, as well as what prizes are coming up. The green checkmark under the progress bar means that you're able to collect that prize. Just below that, you can see a list of some of the more important prizes offered in the grand prizes, and this will update with how many you've won so far during the event. There's also a handy stat tracker that tells you how many towns you've completed and your total progress. The rest of the spreadsheet isn't nearly as interactive, but it contains information that you might find helpful. The strategies page goes over my two recommended strategies while giving a bit more info on the exact breakdown of the various costs and odds of things in case you want to craft your own strategies. The event pass comparison page visually compares the three grand prize tracks so that you can see how far you'll have to go to get extra Sunhaven palaces. The task lists page shows the three task list variants as well as optimal manager levels, but without any of my annotations. And that's about it. Again, this spreadsheet is linked down below, so go check it out. If you have questions or improvements or something's wrong, let me know on my Discord server where you can also discuss the Fellowship event as a whole. Good luck with the event, and I'll see you all next time.